What's up YouTube, CNC3 here, back to do another video. Obviously been a while, like I said, very infrequent with these releases, but I got called to do a tag by Merlin himself, and the community has been dry, I mean, ever since the J-Room and the Facebook group and all that, but I just like to point out I'm covered in the periodic table of elements. I think that's the name. I'm just going to say the periodic table. Yeah, I'm a nerd. But yeah, I'm gonna do this tag, and yeah, I'm gonna do this tag. So let me bring out these questions. I have my answers. Okay, so question one: who do you believe to be the greatest anime hero of all time? Now, I don't think there's one character, but as far, I mean, I can throw some suggestions out there. I think Goku, he's my favorite character, so that answers the second question already. But Goku is definitely there. Gintoki, Gintoki, I think, is kind of like I wouldn't say like an odd choice, but he's kind of like a new, I think, sort of character that not many people are aware of. So yeah, definitely Gintoki. I'll explain some of these: Kenshiro, Astro Boy, Kenshin, Guts, Musashi from Vagabond, Spike, Lupin the Third, Captain Harlock. For those of you guys who have watched the old 70s series of Space Captain Harlock, very old series, and of course I'd have to throw Seiya and Jotaro in there. So yeah, Goku, because he's the archetypical shonen hero now. Just looking at like where shonen is now, and thinking if Goku could be like a modern shonen protagonist, I'm not so sure. Maybe he could be. I mean, because, you know, you have Battle of Gods, and you have the new Frieza movie coming out, which I'm going to be making a video on that after this. But I don't know, like, unlike shonen heroes, he doesn't really rely on his friends, you know, like, one of the themes about Shonen Jump, or just shonen in general, is, like, friendship and the bonds that someone has with someone else, and Goku doesn't really draw from that, so to speak, at least in my opinion, and I think in a lot of other people's opinions. The relationship between him and other people isn't really, like, a basis for his character, like most other shonen protagonists. But yeah, as far as anime goes, he founded an entire character archetype. He's very unique, like I said, in the sense that he doesn't really draw from his friends. Of course, you know, with the whole spirit bond, that's a different story, but yeah, that's just superficial. Yeah, he's hardworking, and yeah, I think he's the best of both worlds. He's simple, yet he can have depth. And he can make some really questionable decisions. And not questionable in terms of, like, if the writing is good or bad. Just in terms of, like, was that the right thing to do as a person? How selfish can the guy get? All those sort of things, I think, make Goku a very interesting and a good character. Gintoki is, in my opinion, the best modern shonen protagonist by a lot, I'd say. Not that there aren't good shonen protagonists, but Gintoki's just so good to me. He's like a mixture if you got, like, Spike and Onizuka, Kenshin, a little bit of Goku in there. All those characters put together. He's basically a man-child like Goku is, but he can also spout Confucius-like wisdom. And he's a gag character. He's by far one of the funniest characters I've ever seen. And I'm not going to talk about my personal connection to Gintoki, but I definitely think he does deserve to be one of the greatest, because not only is Gintama one of the best anime that I've seen, Gintoki is also one of the most unique characters that I've seen. And it's strange because he takes a lot from like other shonen characters and melds them into one, but even when you know that, the way that he portrays like said qualities, it's very unique, in my opinion. So I definitely think he needs to be up there with Goku. Kenshiro is another one, because Kenshiro is the, like Goku and how he was the progenitor of modern shonen, Kenshiro is sort of like the epitome of like what it means to be a manly and badass character. Appeals to a lot of, he's basically like a character archetype like Goku is, and I think he deserves to be in there. His struggle and how he balances his darkness with his humanity, kind of like how Goku does in the Namek arc, I would say, or how that's similar to Goku. Those things, I think, and the tragedy and the pain that you feel from that character, very good. I really appreciate that about his character. So, and he's my third favorite character ever. Actually, those three: Goku 1, Gintoki 2, Kenshiro 3. Those are my three favorite anime characters, or manga characters as well, so yeah. Astro Boy, for the same reason, he's just a shonen icon. Pretty much that. I don't think there. He's kind of like the Mario, in my opinion, if you would say. Like, you can't make, like, a greatest anime hero without Astro Boy in there. You know what I mean? Kenshin is sort of like Gintoki, like I said before, his whole struggle and how he wants to atone for his past and all the killing that he did in the Bakumatsu Rebellion, and how he finally learns to accept himself and realize that he is someone worth protecting and that his life is worth living in the end. Just beautiful writing. Guts, to me, amazing seinen protagonist, and the thing I like about Guts is that he progressively becomes like a darker character. Over the course of the series, like I don't want to say he starts out innocent, but he does start out to be, he does start out initially to be this very, I don't want to say heroic character, but this very soldier-esque character, you know, sort of like an admirable person, if you will. And over the course of the story, because of what Griffith did to him and all the tribulations and trials that he goes through, his character slowly becomes darker. And but what I really like about Guts is his internal struggle with the black dog demon that, you know, because, or I don't even remember the demon with the berserker armor. His struggle to retain his humanity and like how Casca helps him with that, I think is just amazing for a main character. I wouldn't necessarily call him a hero. But just to see that we have like a dark main character out there, and we can see like where the threshers of insanity can take you, very interesting. Miyamoto Musashi is another great seinen character in my opinion. Just because Vagabond is a story of how he becomes Miyamoto Musashi, the greatest swordsman who's ever lived, at least in Japan's history, probably in all of history. Just seeing his development and how he learns what like true strength is. Probably, I think, not probably, it is what makes him a great character. And I know people are gonna put, like, Miyamoto Musashi got soloed by dirt jokes in the comments, but whatever. Out of Guts and Musashi, I actually prefer Musashi more. That's just my, you know, that's just me. Spike, I love Spike. Relaxed, cool, confident. And his story is really about how love changes him. And like Goku, he was kind of pop, but he was a very popular anime character in the West. DBZ, Cowboy Bebop, Hakusho, Toonami, like all those things were responsible for popularizing anime in the Western Hemisphere. And their character, the main characters, were a part of that. So I definitely think Spike is deserving of that. Seeing how like love changes him because of his relationship with Julia. How he's trying to get, how he's trying to like overcome his past is like a major theme throughout the story, and how that's expressed in a Bebop, I think is done pretty well. Lupin the Third is actually Spike before there was a Spike. Actually, Spike's character was based on Lupin the Third, and Lupin to me is a very he at one point he was my favorite seinen character ever, but he's funny. He's kind of like I said, he's kind of like Gintoki, Goku in a bit, in the sense that he can be a very humorous, like gag-like character, but he can also get like serious, and there's like real human drama behind his character. He like his rage, like when you piss him off, he will do anything just to get back at you, and he, like it's kind of like if you guys have read part 7 of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, Johnny, remember how he had like the dark energy, the dark determination. That's kind of what like what Lupin has. His rage is just like so like, ugh, you can really feel it. Captain Harlock is one of my favorite characters also. I definitely think he's up there for best anime heroes ever, because he's the epitome of what it means to be a melancholic character. He's so mysterious. You don't really know too much about him. All you know is that he's a badass and that he's a war grizzled, or that he's a grizzled space pirate. Like, he's been through some shit, he's been through battles, he's seen things, but you don't know like what exactly those situations were, like what he went through. You don't know like what it is exactly, but you can tell. And that mystery and that melancholic nature really sets like a very good mood for the series. And he was really one of the pioneers for anime, so in terms of like popularizing it, not in America, but in Japan. So I definitely think that he deserves that. And Seiya and Jotaro are in this are in there, just because I put Goku and Kenshiro, I think by law, if you will, Seiya and Jotaro need to be in there because Seiya is just an iconic hero, and he's kind of like the impetuous, hot-blooded, youthful shonen protagonist, and Jotaro is kind of like an XP of Kenshiro, if you will, in the sense that he's manly, but the way that JoJo's Bizarre Adventure portrays sort of like those manly moments of what it means to be a badass and what it means to be a man is more flamboyant in nature than what it is in Hokuto no Ken, Fist of the North Star. So those are my picks for the greatest anime heroes of all time. I think you can go with any one of them. Who is my personal favorite main character? I think anyone knows that I was going to say Natsu. I'm just kidding. Goku. Goku is my favorite main character still to this day. I like the fact that he's lovable. He can be funny, but he can also get like very serious at times, and you can feel pain for the character. And he's interesting, you know, when like Grandpa Gohan dies and all that. And talking about that pain, like with that new Frieza trailer that debuted yesterday, the one that revealed Golden Frieza, Frieza's new god form, if you will. That scream that Goku had at the end. When you it's weird when you hear like characters screaming, like it tugs at your heartstrings. That did that for me. Kamina's and Gurren Lagann did the same for me also, in episode 8 or 9, that fateful episode. But I just love the character. I like his journey into becoming a man. I like how he not necessarily becomes a darker character, but he becomes a more adamant character through the series. I like how he has to accept his Saiyan heritage, how his humanity is in direct contrast to the Saiyan evil nature, the violent nature, the one that kills and conquers and does all that terrible stuff, and how the union of those two things is what makes him that Super Saiyan that we see against Frieza. And I also like that I was talking about this earlier. Goku isn't really one that relies on his friends, and I like that because a lot of shonen characters I think tend to really draw on the bonds that they have with like their teammates. Yusuke at the end is realizing at the end of the series is realizing that he's fighting for his friends as well as for himself. Luffy, his bonds with the crew is a very integral part of his character. Gon, his relationship with Killua and the fact that he's his best friend, really drives his character. Jotaro in part 3 and the relationship that he has with the Stardust Crusaders and how we see that all come together at the end with the feels and the tears at the end of part 3, that's another thing that drives his character. Goku to me is not the sort of like when you think Goku, you don't think that oh, his friends, you know. At least to me, that's and I think in a lot of other people's opinions, that's not what comes to mind. It's more about himself. He's kind of like a selfish character, but he's still pure. He's not like an overly selfish character. He's not too overly selfish, but the juxtaposition of his selfishness with his purity and how those come together, that I think is something that I enjoy about Goku. Not that I think I enjoy, I do enjoy it. It's very interesting, in my opinion. But yeah, he's my favorite main character. Probably will always be that. It will probably always be that way. Who is your least favorite character or the most overrated? My least favorite main character is Light Yagami, and again, I'm not saying Light is a bad character. That's not what I'm saying, but I don't like Light. I don't like arrogant characters. I don't like characters that think of can't even talk. I don't like characters that think of themselves as gods. Too arrogant. And he's a serial killer and yeah, just not the kind of character I would like. But Natsu, I know Natsu is a a generic answer, but it's not that I don't like Natsu because of like why the rest of the community hates him, but I don't like Natsu because I don't like his, I don't know, just the pink hair with the annoying voice, in my opinion. No disrespect to the voice actors, but the voice, the pink hair, the over exuberance, yeah, blah, leaves a sour taste in my mouth. Don't really like it. Though I will say, the relationship that he has with Igneel, I think I that is something that I can get behind. Seiya to me is also a character. I don't hate him and I don't dislike him, but I don't really like or love him either. He's sort of like that character in the middle, because he's too hot-blooded. He's I don't really find him interesting, and he's too archetypical, I think. Doesn't really captivate me. What is your favorite team slash main cast of characters? This one was tough, but it's between the Z Fighters, obviously, DBZ fan, but and Yorozeya. I love the Z Fighters and I love the Yorozeya, but you know, it's not so much that the humans hurt the Z Fighters. It's just that because I don't think they digress in terms of being in terms of their character. I don't think they digress at all, at all. It's just that the human characters are not as really good as the Saiyans and Piccolo, and you know, when I say Saiyans, I'm not counting Goten and Trunks, which you can if you want, but compared to the main Saiyans and Piccolo, it's just that the humans are I think are so beneath them, not only in strength but in terms of character, that it creates this image that the humans are like this burden to the Z Fighters, and I don't think that to be the case. But yeah, the Yorozeya and Z Fighters, like I said, I like seeing Goku and how he accepts the fact that he's not human, how he becomes more adamant over the course of the series, how he becomes more strict and stern, while still retaining that relaxed, friendly, affable personality about him. Vegeta, how love changes him throughout the story, how he goes from loving himself, only himself, to loving other people like Bulma and Trunks. Piccolo is sort of like a fusion between Goku and Vegeta in the sense that he has to figure out who he is, but he is also changed by love. So I love Piccolo for that. Gohan becomes more independent over the course of the series, and how he becomes, you know, an adult. I like seeing that. Trunks and the relationship that he has with Vegeta, how he inherits pride, what Vegeta means to him, and how he changes into Android's arc because of that. That's something that I like. Krillin I also like. I love Krillin because he's sort of like the normal person, if you will. Tien is dedicated, delusional, call him what you will, and Yamcha is just comedy. I mean, even though he gets his ass kicked, I mean, he's still a funny character. And Chaozu is just there. He's like a cute mascot, if you will. But I love Yorozeya as well. Yorozeya, Gintoki, I love fucking Gintoki. He's one of my heroes. He really is. Shinpachi's the straight man, the sort of character that I think everyone can relate to in the series. And Kagura and Sadaharu. Sadaharu's the cute mascot, and Kagura. She's like a female Goku and Luffy, if you will. She eats a lot. She's like a child. She's an alien. She's more. I would say. I don't know. She's like a mix between Goku and Luffy, except in female form. But yeah, I love her too. Those are my two favorite main casts, but Team Urameshi is definitely up there also. Team Urameshi is definitely up there also. It's just that when it comes to Yusuke, Hiei, and Kurama compared to Goku, Vegeta, and Piccolo, I would choose Goku, Vegeta, and Piccolo. And I would put Yusuke, Hiei, and Kurama beneath them, in my opinion. That's the only reason that I said that I didn't put Urameshi on the same level as the Z Fighters and Yorozeya. Who is your favorite female protagonist? That's easy. My favorite female protagonist is Motoko Kusanagi. She's basically female Solid Snake, if you will, and she's from the series Ghost in the Shell. I don't know, she's suave, she's calm, she's collected, she's confident, she's cool, and she's a cyborg, so like the fact that she has human emotion and like how she deals with that and how that really pushes her, I guess, her quest, if you will, to find out who she is. All those sort of things make me very interested in the character. Plus, she's a badass, so that's always a plus. But some other of my favorite female characters, Android 18, definitely. And I think many people would gloss over the fact that 18 also had some sort of like personal tragedy, in the sense that she and 17, or I should call them by like their real names, Lapis and Lazuli, were turned into androids or artificial humans. Those of you guys who watch the sub, they were turned into artificial humans against their will by Dr. Gero, and so that's a very interesting place for personal tragedy for the character. Plus, she's a hot blonde and she's a tsundere, and yeah, those are my weaknesses. Speaking about hot blondes and tsundere, Sukuyo, oh my god, I love Sukuyo. Sukuyo from Gintama, she's ultimate waifu. Verona from Durarara, I love her. And not only Edda, I was going to say Edda from Black Lagoon, because she is my favorite Black Lagoon female. But I'm just going to throw it out and say all Black Lagoon females. Revy, Edda, Shenhua, Roberta, Balalaika, the list goes on. I love them. Faye is another one of my favorites, how she tries to find out her identity and how she has to adapt herself to an era which is so beyond anything that she knew, trying to find like what her own identity is in this new age. Very interesting concept. Fu and how she becomes more independent over the course of Samurai Champloo. I like her. She's cute. Dorothy from The Big O. She's an android, but she starts to have human emotions. I like that about her. Angel, also from The Big O. Very much like Sukuyo, and I think a little bit of Android 18, I would say. She's a flirtatious. She doesn't know who she really is. She feels like she's being used as a tool in the grand scheme of things in The Big O. Fujiko Mine, and how she tries to find freedom. That's another thing that I love. And she's from Lupin the Third. What freedom like really means to her. She's sexy also. Shane from Bakano. You guys are noticing the theme here. Freedom, independence, not being used as a tool, personal tragedy. I love all those things in female characters. Shane is, because, you know, she's mute. She can't talk, right? And I guess, I don't know, I like her. She's badass, she uses knives, she's good looking. And how she tries to be something more than a tool for Huey LaFerrette, her father, or her grandfather. I forget, in Bakano, something that I also like. Ennis is the same way. I like Ennis. She's kind of like Shane, except her Huey is a Zilliard Cortez, because she's like a homunculi and all that stuff. And you know, both those women are changed by love. Vito for Shane and Firo for Ennis. So I like that. The last female character that I want to bring up is Seras from Helsing. I like her. I don't know. She's busty, cute. She's a vampire. She's badass. Guns. She has it all. I love Seras. And her vampire identity and like what that means to her, I think, is a very interesting point to draw things from for her. I don't know if that was that a correct sentence. I think it was. But yeah, those are my favorite female protagonist characters. But Kusanagi is my favorite female main character. Who is your favorite anime sidekick? This was kind of hard because I was going to say Kuwabara from Yu Yu Hakusho, because manly, he's funny. He's the funniest character, definitely, in Yu Yu Hakusho to me. And I just like how he grows like from this punk into like an actual like scholar. But Krillin is also up there for me, because like I said, I love Krillin, and he's ordinary. He's normal in a series that is not normal. And then again, he's not even really that normal, but he's the most normal in my opinion, besides Mr. Satan and, you know, some of the other obvious choices. But he doesn't have a nose, and I'm calling him normal, but I was gonna say Kuwabara or Krillin, but after watching some of the other tag videos, I'm actually going to say Daisuke Jigen from Lupin the Third. I love Jigen. Jigen is just this rootin' tootin' old man, hip man with a gun who could shoot a can off the top of your head. But yeah, I love Jigen. He's awesome. He's just an awesome character, a badass gunslinger, and the strife that he has in his past, I feel for the character. I think it was in Fujiko, yeah, the a woman called Fujiko Mine, in which he loved a person, like loved a woman, and like how that affected him throughout the rest of his life. So yeah, Jigen is my favorite anime sidekick. Who's my favorite anime anti-hero? Vegeta, but it took me a while to like Vegeta. Interesting fact about Vegeta was that I did not like Vegeta until the Majin Buu arc, and there were two reasons. It's not that I didn't find him a good character. I thought he was a decent character, and then the Majin Buu arc happened, and then that's where he became great. That's where I thought he was the best character in the Majin Buu arc. But the fact that he was unapologetic for killing innocent people, he was selfish, ruthless, conniving, underhanded, the fact that kind of acted like a bitch. I don't want to say like act like a bitch, but he was cowardly when he like ran away from Frieza in the second form, when he left Goku to fight Ginyu and Jace. Like all those things just made me not really like him, and I didn't find him interesting because he didn't care about anyone but himself. Even in the Cell arc, or the Androids arc, when Jiro blasted Trunks and Bulma, when they were intervening on Piccolo and Dr. Jiro's fight, he didn't save them. So it's just like, I didn't find anything interesting about the character. I didn't like his mannerisms, and he talked a lot of shit only to get his ass kicked, and he was constantly obsessed with beating Goku, and that was what most of his dialogue was about, and I don't know. I just didn't find that interesting. But then I liked the Majin Buu arc version of Vegeta because he got over all that. He got over his pride. He was capable of loving someone other than himself. And yeah, he was not insufferable anymore. And I'm excited to see like what he does in Resurrection of F. Very excited. I would probably say I might have enjoyed Vegeta more in Battle of Gods than I did Goku. And that's saying a lot. But yeah, Vegeta is definitely my favorite anime anti-hero. I love the guy. I really do. But besides Vegeta, I also loved Hiei, Alucard, Kenpachi, Lelouch, Revy, Greed from FMA, Scar, and Tao Ren and Guts. I love all those anti-heroes. Funny enough, I actually liked Hiei the most, and then the Majin Buu arc happened, and then Vegeta just became Vegoda. Vegoda. But yeah, that answers the questions, and I can ask questions of my own. But you know what, Merlin? I'm going to one-up you, and I'm going to ask two questions. So the first question I'm going to ask is, what traits do your favorite main characters share? And so for me, some of my main characters, interesting fact about them is that some of them killed their own teachers or mentors or masters, Goku, Kenshin, and if I were to go into video games, Solid Snake, and then one other character, but I don't want to spoil someone from a video game. And when I say Kenshin killed his master, I meant he supposedly killed his master. Remember with the whole Amakakuru Ryu no Hiramaki, but Hikaseijuru survived because it was a blunt blade, or it was a Sakobato. Another character is what's his name? Jin from Samurai Champloo. He killed his own master. I feel like I don't know. It's just a unique trait that some of my favorite characters share. Goku killed Grandpa Gohan, and I hope like that's something that is touched upon earlier because even though we saw the guilt that he had when he was fighting Vegeta in the Saiyan arc, when he turned Great Ape and he realized that he was the one who killed Gohan, Grandpa Gohan, I would like to see that be more of like a place of like darkness for Goku's character. I would really like to see that. Other traits are that they're very relaxed, they're affable, they're friendly, they're cool, calm, collected, they're just like detached. They're just like, ah, what's up, man? Like, you know, they're easygoing, lighthearted a little bit. They can be funny, they can be badass, they can switch between the two, and then yeah. Those are the traits I think my most favorite main characters share. Which, and then my ninth question, or my second bonus question is, which main characters do you have a lot in common with? For me, that would be Gohan, Inugami. It's kind of arrogant for me to say this a little bit, but Gintoki a little bit, Spike a little bit, and Jotaro a little bit. And it's just because, like, I respect those characters so much, and it's just kind of like, I shouldn't say that I have things in common with them, so I'll only say what I have in common with Gohan and Inugami. It's not so much just Gohan; it's the Sun family. The Sun family in DBZ resembles my own family quite a lot, in the sense that I am the I am the eldest sibling, the eldest, and. People did regard me as smart. I wear glasses now. I'm kind of lame. I was kind of a crybaby when I was a kid, and I learned to become like more independent. My dad, in some ways, resembles Goku in a lot, I guess. I think so, in the sense that he was. They both are like country hicks, but my dad ended up getting his PhD in chemistry. So, yeah, and I think that kind of mirrors Goku's journey into him being just this nobody with a power level of 2 in the countryside, yet he becomes arguably the universe's greatest martial artist, maybe, considering the whole thing with Frieza, Beerus, and Whis, and all that. And then Chi-Chi is a lot like my mom in the sense that she's always nagging me to study. Brown parents know what I'm talking about. Or brown people, brown subs know what I'm talking about. Chi-Chi is a stereotypical brown person. So, yeah. But yeah, I do relate a lot with Gohan. And just the Sun family in general. And my little brother, I don't know, with Goten, I don't know. I don't know about that, but yeah. Ikiru Inugami is a character from Wolf Guy Ukami no Manchu, and I share a lot in common with him in the sense of the fact that I've had a lot of bad stuff happen in my life, and I'm not gonna talk about it, but I do feel that, I don't know, just seeing him struggle and suffer, and I can relate with that pain, you know? I'll leave it at that. I don't want to get too deep into that. Maybe I'll share it someday, but yeah, that's my tag video, so I guess I'm supposed to tag other people. So I'm a tag Blazebolt Sniper. I'm a tag, and I'm a tag. Yeah, I'm a tag the two Blazes, Blazebolt Sniper and AnimeBlaze.com. And up in flames, if you're watching this video, you can do it if you want to, because I know you there. I think you don't upload that many videos anymore. So yeah, that's my list. That's my tag. And I'm Merlin. One thing before I go. Most complex does not mean it's the best character, okay? I don't know. That just rubbed me the wrong way when you said it in your tag video. I'm not. I don't have anything against you. It just rubbed me the wrong way a little bit. I hate the whole argument. Complexity is greater than simplicity. At least when it comes to a character. Doesn't make sense to me. But yeah, that's my tag video. Thank you guys for watching. And,